today's Krunker video, we're going to be talking about how Krunker just added NFTs. Yes, you heard me right, NFTs. An NFT is a non-fungible token. The best way I could describe it, it's kind of like art that you can sell and then buy and then sell and then buy. It has stuff to do with crypto. It's very complex. I don't quite understand it myself, but they did add it inside of Krunker. Now, before we get into the video, I will say I'm not a financial advisor. Please do not sue me. I don't care. No. I know little about what I'm talking about, but I'm trying my absolute best, so I hope you guys do enjoy. But yeah, there was a new update 5.1.1, and as you guys can see under general, they updated terms and conditions around item sellings and NFTs. And they also added a small market overhaul, added hover tool tips to inventory and skin lists. So we're gonna be going over all of this, talking about what all of this means, and I hope it all makes sense. Now, if you guys do go on to enjoy this video, please leave a like, as it does help with the YouTube algorithm. And then please let me know what you guys think about NFTs in the comments down below, specifically like Krunker NFTs. And also, if you guys are be buying any Krunkies for Krunker Season 5, please use creator code Zorable. It is by far the best way to support the channel. Let's hop right into Krunker NFTs. So Krunker NFTs, what does it mean? Can I make millions? Can I make a dollar? I don't know. Even though I just said this, I will preface this again. I am very not knowledgeable over this subject. I'm not really the person to be talking about it, but I am the Krunker guy, so I will be making Krunker video. So like I said in the new update, they did add an update that said update the terms and conditions around item selling and NFTs. We go to terms and conditions and scroll through it a bunch. I wish they made this easier to look at. It's like I'm getting flashbanged. And also just like a lot of stuff to read. Now I could be blind or just stupid, or maybe a little bit of both. I can't find anything about item selling specifically, but there is this thing right here that says non-fungible tokens, NFTs, and unique assets. So let's just go ahead and read this real quick. For NFT and unique assets offered and created and offered by Krunker, the copyright conditions apply. These objects can be used on the Krunker platform and can only be traded in defined sections of the game or on authorized third-party platforms. Each of these assets has a unique identifier and defined quantity limitation. I feel like I'm reading the Matrix right now. The user/player is responsible to keep any security information related to these assets safe. Yendis Entertainment Pty Ltd. Yendis AG are not liable for any loss of such information and the consequences of such loss. User-created assets can be used in the user-created games. These can be linked to NFTs offered and traded on third-party platforms. For any transactions on these third-party platforms like MetaMask, OpenSea, the conditions of the platforms and operators apply. Yendis can apply a transaction-based fee for the user of use of the interface used by the creators. Yendis Entertainment blah 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 is not liable for the use of NFT trading platforms or the interface to Krunker. Now, I don't know what I just read, but I think pretty much what they're saying is you can sell NFTs on certain websites and on Krunker, but they are also not liable for anything bad that happens through NFTs. Now, I didn't quite understand what I just read. I mean, I understood it because I read it, but I don't really understand what it means. I'm trying to look for like, can you sell items? Should you sell items? Or if it's just, if it all just falls under that NFT list. So as I just read, Krunker NFTs are a thing that can be traded and sold on certain websites. And if we go to the market, it looks a lot different. I believe they updated a majority of the icons for literally everything. Everything just seems bigger now. I don't know if it's my CSS or what, but everything most definitely seems a ton bigger now. And now you can also hover over things. And as you guys can see, it shows the price of its estimate, its name, and everything like that. So that's pretty cool. But if we go to inventory, this is where things start getting weird. So as you guys can see on a majority of these top items, you see this icon in the bottom right of the item. And that icon is the Ethereum icon, which is a cryptocurrency. Yes, it's a cryptocurrency. So some items can be sold, like all of my unobtainables can be sold. These two contrabands can be sold. But however, on non-tradable items like the Gumballer and stuff like that, you cannot sell it as an NFT. One thing I will say about this whole NFT system, and I'll be honest one more time, I have no idea what's happening. I have no idea what any of this means. I thought the NFTs were going to be like super rare items. You do have to remember there's still an NFT rarity, but I am somewhat confused by that now since a majority of my items are NFTs. Or maybe I can just sell them on like NFT websites and they're not NFTs. I really feel like they should explain this more, and maybe they are going to explain it more. And I'll say this for the 17th time this video, I am the last person to be talking about anything like this, but I do think it's super duper interesting. I'm just confused the fact that there is an NFT rarity and then I could list these on OpenSea now. Like, I'm gonna keep it a buck with you. Who's gonna be buying my bunny slippers with Ethereum? Who? Or even like some of like this, the gate to hell from Moss. Who's gonna be buying this? Mysterious Ore makes sense.
sense.
And even all of the unobtainables make sense since they're so rare. Like, I think the least rare unobtainable still has very few owners. The most owned unobtainable on the rarest item list is Scout's Honor with 29. So it's not incredibly rare, but it is super duper rare compared to like the 20 million people who have played this game. And for example, Mysterious Orb, I believe I'm still the only owner for this item. So that would make sense to sell. And I'm the only person in the world who owns this at the moment. So I wonder if I could sell this for a lot in theory. However, if we hover over it and you see list on OpenSea, you click on that as much as you want, nothing happens at the moment. And I assume it's because they don't have this system ready yet. Now, I don't know what OpenSea is, if I'm being 1000% honest with you. It seems like it's the largest NFT marketplace. So when we click on this, it seems like you can just create or sell stuff on OpenSea. Huh. Is this legal? Who is doing this? Owned by How Did You Know Me? So some random person just selling NFTs on here? So this is not Krunker? I don't know. This whole thing is super duper confusing to me. As much as I think it's really, really cool, I'm not quite sure how good of an idea NFTs are for Krunker. Because as much as it does seem like a good idea with like unobtainables, a majority of the player base doesn't have unobtainables. And with a lot of these low tier contrabands that are sellable or tradable on OpenSea, a lot of the player base is young. So I feel like a lot of weird financial things are going to go on with this. For the older users, I think it's just gonna be what it is. Like, if I can sell my Frostbite for like $2,500, I will gladly do so. But imagine little Jimmy, he's, I don't know, 13 years old, and he has a Frostbite for some reason. Young people are malleable, impressionable, and stuff like that. What if little Jimmy was approached by an older person and was like, hey, Frostbite's pretty cool, I'll give you $100. And they're like, oh wow, Frostbite, I like Frostbite, it's rare, and $100, that's a lot of money to me. And so they sell it and they get scammed and stuff like that. I do see that happening, and I obviously Krunker is not liable for that. I just don't know how good of an idea it is for this game. And also, that brings me to my next point. I feel like a lot of like these unobtainable items will go for a lot, or should go for a lot. I'm not gonna put prices on them because I frankly don't understand how NFTs work, but I feel like Frostbite, for example, could sell for a few thousand. However, the majority of Krunker is younger people, and they obviously don't have thousands of dollars to give me. So I really don't know how well this is gonna go. And maybe if someone just randomly stumbles across Krunker NFTs, they'll think it's investable and good to invest in. But I feel like for the general Krunker player, the whole NFT thing will go generally untouched. And that's just the thing. I'm not necessarily sure who this is for, because typically when they release a Krunker update, it's for everybody. I don't know the rules and stipulations behind NFTs, but it feels like mixing a younger player base with NFTs is a bad idea. Thanks, Good Girl Wrong. But as we've read, Krunker is not liable. But however, that's just weird to me a little bit, because I am almost a 23-year-old adult, and I have no idea what any of this means. I feel like I'm going to be just as confused as those people. Now, obviously, do your research. That's probably what I should have did before this video. But I just don't know if this is a good idea to mix like a younger player base with like investing. Like, what if someone steals their mom's credit card and buys my Frostbite for $10,000, and then their parents are mad because their child bought a $10,000 block game item? I mean, I guess it has value. I don't know. Please, like I said in the beginning of the video, please let me know what you guys think about NFTs in the comments down below. NFTs normally, or just Krunker NFTs. Like I said, I don't really understand the whole NFT rarity. Like, I don't know if these unobtainables are counted as NFTs. They do have the Ethereum logo on it though. But then there's some items that don't have it, which aren't tradable, which makes sense. But then, like I said, there's a whole NFT rarity. So maybe these aren't NFTs. Maybe you can sell the NFTs as NFTs. And maybe OpenSea will just be a marketplace to sell items for Krunker. That's what I'm kind of getting from this, but like I said, I don't really know. I think for there to be an absolute fair, real way to sell your Krunker items would be super duper cool, but like I said, it will come with its problems. But for now, I really think that's gonna do it for Krunker NFTs. That's really all we have. To break it down, they overhauled the market a little bit, which looks nice. They're bringing NFTs to the game, which you can sell on OpenSea for Ethereum. And then there's also items that have the Ethereum logo on them, and I'm assuming you can just sell these items for money, or Ethereum, I guess, which can be turned into money. The more and more I sit here and make this video, the more and more I myself am getting confused, and I'm really hoping that you guys aren't getting confused, because there's a lot of things that you guys probably don't know about. I remember when Season 5 first came out, and I mentioned the fact that there was an NFT rarity, and a lot of you guys were assuming that it meant not for trade, when I knew it meant non-fungible token, because NFTs are pretty big right now, and I've looked into them. But maybe you guys haven't, you guys don't know what NFTs are, maybe you guys don't know what Ethereum is, I don't know. I hope this video made sense. I explained how it made sense to me, so hopefully it makes sense to you. But from my understanding, right now, This is kind of speculation, but kind of like an educated guess. My guess is that everything that has the Ethereum logo on it is you can sell it for Ethereum or money on OpenSea. And whenever the NFT rarity comes out, you can sell those as NFTs on OpenSea. That's my best guess. I don't know, to be honest with you. And please, if you guys are more knowledgeable about this subject than I am, please let me know in the comments down below and I'll pin your comment. But regardless, I think this can be really, really good for Krunker. Like I said, I would love to sell some of my items because I'm an adult and I have bills to pay. And if someone wanted to buy my Frostbite for $2,500 worth of Ethereum, I would be lying if I'd say no. Even like Mysterious Orb, even though it's like my rarest unobtainable and I unboxed it, someone offered the right price for it, I'd for sure sell it. Same with a lot of my contrabands. So this is going to be super duper interesting. I think this can be good for Krunker. I also do at the same time think this could be very problematic for Krunker, but we'll just have to see. Whatever this means, I am excited for it. And I think it will be nice to be able to sell items legally to the terms of service. But I think that's going to be all for the Krunker NFTs for now. I'll say this one last time. I am not the person to be talking about this. I'm not a financial advisor. I have no idea what any of this means. But I try to explain my best to you, so I hope you guys did enjoy. And I think that's going to do it for Krunker NFTs.
I'm finna be rich, baby.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video once again. And as always, it's been your boy, CJ or Sorable. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.